Okay, dear students, already you learn regarding the lymphatic system, and yesterday we learn regarding the lymph, its composition and functions, how it is play important role in the immunizations or invading the microorganisms, as well as the locations of lymph node, then its functions and certain features of the lymph nodes. Then finally we learn regarding the spleen. Okay, spleen is also lymphatic organs, it play important role in the phagocytosis, and it is also having the capability to kill the microorganism, because the red pulp and white pulp, they are consist of the macrophages, phagocytes, beta lymphocytes, T lymphocytes. So due to that, they are involved in the to killing the microorganisms. But the spleen is also involved in the productions of the blood cells, but it is only possible in intrauterine life. When the womb is between 3 to 5th months, the site for synthesis of blood cells is a spleen, thymus gland and liver, because the RBM is not matured. Still the bones are under the development stage. So due to that, were the blood cells are they synthesized in the spleen, thymus gland as well as the liver. Okay, so and spleen is one of the major organs of the lymphatic organs. Okay, so it's play important role in the regulations of the immunity. And any swelling of the spleen, it indicates we are suffering from the microbial infections, or during the stress, some abnormal cavity just above the stomach, one part will be the swell, that is the spleen. So that indicates, so that candidate or we are suffering from the stress. Due to stress only, the size of spleen was increases. So that was a diagnosis are signified with the help of the to clearly locating the locations of the spleen in our body or in the patient's body. Just it is present in the left side, just above the stomach or just below the diaphragm or just below your heart. So if any swelling is there, so that indicates, then you counsel the patients, what is their habits, how is their family history, work history, then workplace. So there was somewhere you can got some stress is there. So then you know what are the conditions of stress, whether the stress is harmful to the organs or still it is under the beginning stage. So where you simply can observe the size of the spleen. If it is swell, means that indicates, so that stress is start to damage the organs. Okay, so where there is need to special to keep the medical attentions on the patients. Okay, so with the help of simple observation of the spleen by putting the hand at the abdominal cavity, so then it is a possible. Okay, so today we learn regarding the lymphatic disorder. First one is the lymph edema. So the name, the word is end with the edema, it indicates somewhere the fluid can be accumulated. Okay, so that edema is nothing but the accumulations of fluid in the particular part of the body, so that indicates the edema. So here the word is lymph edema, it means in the lymph or in the lymphatic system, the lymph can be accumulated, or the body fluid can be accumulated in the lymphatic system. So that condition was known as the lymph edema. It is commonly seen in the legs. Okay, so those are working on the tables and chair, or those are working in the sit by sitting a single place for longer duration. So those people, they are commonly, so they are suffering from the swelling of the leg initially. If they are not take any care, so then that becomes the lymph edema. It is look like a this, that is swelling over our leg. Okay, so this is a common feature. So those are working on by sitting a single places. Okay, so reason for lymph edema is the development of the scar tissues in lymphatic duct due to surgery by radiations. Okay, any radiation surgery, so that was responsible for the development of the formations of excess tissues. that is the death tissues. That is scar nothing but malfunction, death tissue. If it is formed in the lymphatic duct, means so that was responsible for accumulation of fluid in a particular places. And as well as during the cancer surgery, the doctors, they are removed the lymph node. So due to removal of lymph node in the particular places, the occlusion is occurs or the passage can be blocked. Okay, so due to that also the leg, that is lymphedema, is occurs. Another one is the infection by microorganisms, bacteria or any other things. So that were also the lymphedema is occurs. Or any inflammatory diseases, that is inflammations in our body, that was also responsible to cause of the lymphedema. And cardiovascular disease, especially increase the blood pressure and decrease the blood pressure in both conditions. So the leg or swell or the lymphedema is occurs in the case of increase the blood pressure, so where the drainage is not properly occurs due to increased blood pressure, and as well as so due to decrease the blood pressure, then also the lymphedema is occurs. Or any injury and trauma, okay, any injury to the leg where the tissue can damages, the blood vessels are damages, due to that in particular places the infiltrations of fluid can be taken plus. Okay, so that was responsible for to cause of the swelling of the leg or lymphedema. So regarding risk factor, it is more common in the old age, and as well as it is more common in the obesity or obese people. So those people, they having the more body weight in them, so there is a pressure is increases on the leg due to increase the body weight when they are standing positions in the single places. Okay, so due to that the infiltrations of fluid can take place, that were responsible to cause of the lymphedema. Okay, so then next one is the rheumatoid arthritis and psoriatic arthritis. So these are also another risk factor that was caused the lymphedema. So regarding the drawbacks regarding the lymphedema, it after the swelling, if you are not controlled by any techniques, with the medications, with the therapy or any other technique, if you are not controlled, if you are not treat lymphedema, means after that the accumulation of fluid that was infectious, it contains various hazardous substances, waste materials and bacteria, viruses. So those are responsible to cause of the breakage of the blood vessels in the leg. Okay, due to that the fluid can be sore out due to breakage of blood vessels. So that finally it can damage the complete the leg tissues. Okay, so where the final option is, there is a chance of to remove the leg, and in the same time so that fluid can be recirculated in our body. So that's why, so there is a need to control the lymphedema in the initial phase. Okay dear students, if you are sitting in the single place for attending the online classes or any purpose, it is a more common in the girls and women, especially in the housewives. So they are completely sitting in the single places, involved in the work. Okay, so where it is more common, if initially you can detect and you can treat, otherwise it was responsible for the breakage of the blood vessels in the leg, and as well it is more infectious fluid. With the infected fluid, it cannot be filtered because it can accumulate here only. So due to that, so the complete the tissues of leg, even the healthy tissue, they will be the rupture, they will be the malfunction. Okay, completely we can lose the our sensations of the leg, or we can lose the all locomotor activity. So that's why initially you should be treat the lymphedema. So here my questions for you is, so what is the treatment, local treatment for the lymphedema in initial stages? Okay, so anyone should be know. Okay, so that is local treatment. I simply tell you, so when blood pressure is decreases, okay, so that due to decreased blood pressure, so that fluid cannot be pumped upper side, because from the leg the blood can be pumped towards the heart opposite to the gravitational forces. So those blood return from brain to the heart, so that has a only having 15 mmHg pressure required, sufficient, less than 15,
So that because it is moving towards the gravitational forces. Okay, but the blood is moving from leg to the heart. It is the against the gravitational process. It can require about 30 mmHg pressure. That is venous pressure, not the systolic pressure, not the blood pressure. There is a venous blood pressure in the leg that should be required 30 mmHg. Okay, so due to condition, the decreased blood pressure, so that pressure cannot be reaches. So due to that, the fluid cannot be pumped in the upper side, so that was left in the leg. That is one reason, due to decrease the blood pressure. And second one is increase the blood pressure. Okay, you are thinking like, so if the blood pressure increase means it can rapidly move towards the heart. That is wrong. Definitely it can move towards the heart, but increased blood pressure in the venous, that was responsible for ruptures of the veins, ruptures of the capillaries. So due to rupture, the infiltration fluid in the leg was taken plus. So that's why the increased blood pressure and the decreased blood pressure, both are risk factors for the to cause of the lymph edema. So my questions for you, according to blood pressure, okay, so how you can manage the lymph edema if it is present in you, your patients, your neighbor or your parents, because you are able to give the therapy. Okay, therapy means not only you can give the medications correct, okay, without medication also you can control the disorders or diseases or conditions, or you can reverse the abnormal physiology of the persons buying your ideas. If you're applying the therapy along with medication, means the recovery of the patients from the abnormal conditions, so that should be the more rapidly as compared to alone medications. So that is the rule of the pharmacies. Okay, the pharmacies, so they can advise the patients. Okay, so how you can advise? Okay, because I simply give you the clue regarding decreased blood pressure is also responsible for lymphedema, or increased blood pressure also responsible for lymphedema. Okay, by sitting the single place, there is chance of pressure on the blood vessel. The blood vessels can be ruptured. So due to rupture, the fluid can be accumulated. Okay, or any scar, any abnormal growth of tissues inside the blood vessels or lymphatic system, lymph node, due to surgery by radiation, that is also block the drainage system by lymphatic system. Due to that, the fluid can accumulate at particular places. Now my questions for you is, so on the basis of blood pressure, how you can manage? If you know the blood pressure is decreases, due to that lymphedema occurs, or the blood pressure increases, then the lymphedema occurs. So my first solution for you is, you control the blood pressure. Okay, simply, you can give the medications, or you give the advice, you control the media, that is the blood pressure. Then it can be helpful for to treatment of the lymphedema. Any other? Okay. So if you have any idea? Girls? Anyone? Sir, aisa kiya to aisa hota hai. Yeah. मूवमेंट करना चाहिए, दैट इज अ रेगुलर एक्सरसाइज. ओके, वॉकिंग, लोकोमोशंस. ओके, और क्या कर सकते हैं? आप किए होंगे ना 12वीं में, लिख 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 के हाथ दुखते वक्त, तो हाथ को क्या करते थे आप लोग दुखते वक्त? ओके, लिख लिख के हाथ स्वेल होता था आपका, अब तब क्या करते थे? आपके कर्चिप बांधते थे कि नहीं हाथ को? ओके, एग्जाम होने तक कर्चिप बांध के ऐसे ग्रिप हाथ को आने, या स्पोर्ट्स खेलते वक्त बैंड डालते हाथ में, क्यों डालते? ग्रिप आना चाहिए. ओके, ग्रिप, प्रेशर की वजह से हाथ में ग्रिप आता, लेग में ग्रिप आता, और स्पोर्ट्स आप खेल सकते. और लिखते वक्त भी आप लोग क्या करते हो? लोग हाथ दुखते वक्त तो कर्चिप बांधते, या दस्ती बोलते हम लोग, वो बांधते. क्यों बांधते? या टाई बैंड बांधते. क्यों बांधते? That can create the grip in your hand. ओके वहां पे ब्लड की जगह पे ये होता है तो यू कैन राइट द ओके सो लाइक दैट ओके यू कैन रैप द रैपर्स क्लॉथ अराउंड द लेग लेग के अराउंड को टाइटली क्लॉथ ओके क्लॉथ को रैप करो ओके सो दैट रैप क्लॉथ रैप्ड सो दैट थेरेपी वॉज हेल्पफुल फॉर टू पुल द ब्लड इन टू द सर्कुलेशन नॉट ब्लड दैट इज फ्लूड ओके यहाँ पे कपड़े से अगर आप रैप करते हो इसके लिए कपड़ा मिलता है ओके अगर पूरा लेग को रैप करके रखते हो आप देख सकते हैं मार्केट में लेग को रैप किए सो रहता है प्लास्टर टाइप बट दैट वॉज द क्लॉथ प्लास्टर इज अ परमानेंट सोल्यूशन बट इज नॉट फॉर हियर दैट इज फॉर द बोन ब्रोकेज यहाँ पे बोन ब्रेक हो सो रहता बट हियर यू टेक द क्लॉथ क्लॉथ लीजिए पैर को करेक्ट बांधिए राउंड करके टू टाइट ओके डेली इन द नाइट टाइम एंड विड्रॉल इन द मॉर्निंग्स नॉट फॉर 24 hours 24 hours के लिए मत बांधिए अदरवाइज इट कैन क्रिएट सम प्रॉब्लम्स ओके तो दैट रैपरिंग डेली इज हेल्पफुल फॉर टू पुल द ब्लड पुल द फ्लूड इन साइड द लिम्फेटिक वेसल टूवर्ड्स द हार्ट उसको पुल करने को हेल्प होता है इट इज अ वन टेक्निक ओके बाय रैपरिंग द क्लॉथ और एवरी वन पर्सन दे हैविंग द फ्रिज इन देयर होम घर में फ्रिज है यू टेक द आइस आइसिंग कीजिए पैर के ऊपर ओके एक बड़ा सा आइस लीजिए सो आइस लेके लेग के ऊपर आइसिंग कीजिए ओके ऊपर हिलाना मतलब मसाज करना चाहिए आइस से सो दैट आइसिंग इज हेल्पफुल फॉर टू कॉज द कंस्ट्रिक्शंस ऑफ कैपिलरी ओके ब्लड वेसल्स को कॉन्स्ट्रिक्ट करता है सो ड्यू टू कंस्ट्रिक्शन दैट फ्लूड कैन यू पुल इन साइड द लिम्फेटिक सिस्टम्स आ लिम्फेटिक वेसल देन इट कैन कम टूवर्ड्स द अवर हार्ट दैट इज बाई आइसिंग मेथड्स आर इफ यू आर एक्सपर्ट ओके इफ यू आर गिव एक्सपर्टेशन ओके सेम लिंक यूज कीजिए टू जॉइन द क्लास बिकॉज आज यहाँ पे थोड़ा प्रॉब्लम है मैं ओके ये बाथरूम का भी आवाज़ आता बार बार ओके इसमें जूम में इसका मीनिंग नहीं है कि कोई बाथरूम में बैठ के पढ़ रहा है ये जूम का डिफॉल्ट है ओके प्रॉब्लम है कभी बीच में कुछ भी आवाज़ करता है इसलिए इरिटेट मत हो जाए सो इट इज प्रॉब्लम रिलेटेड टू द जूम्स इटसेल्फ ओके ओके आइसिंग कीजिए सो दैट आइसिंग is helpful for to decrease the capillary size or blood vessel size and create the pressure on the capillaries capillary blood vessel ke pressure create karta hu tissue contact karke so that is also helpful for to pull the fluid towards the head or towards the heart so these are technique or if you are expert agar aap expert hai injection dene ko aata hai then directly you can use the sodium okay sodium injection milta hai आप वेसल्स के अंदर इंजेक्शन दे सकते हो सो दिस सोडियम एनहांस द प्रेशर ड्यू टू दैट द फ्लूड कैन पुल टुवर्ड्स योर हार्ट ओके बट बाय इंजेक्शंस ऑफ सोडियम यू टेक द प्रिकॉशंस उन्हें हाइपरटेंशन नहीं रहना चाहिए. इफ दे हैव हाइपरटेंशन मींस लिम्फेडिमा इज करेक्टेड बट स्टिल द ब्लड प्रेशर इज इंक्रीजेस. थोड़ा प्रिकॉशंस आता है. ओके, सो दैट यू शुड बी टेक. या आप कोई भी विलेज से है, रूरल एरिया से, उनको आइडिया है अगर हम बचपन में हम कुछ भी काटे तो साल्ट और माटी मिट्टी लगाते थे हाथ को. ओके, गेहूँ गेहूँ में से जो मिट्टी निकाल के उसमें साल्ट रब करके वो हाथ को लेप बनाते थे. सो इन दोज आर फ्रॉम द विलेजेस, जो विलेज से उनको आइडिया है कि गेहूँ में क्या मैं मिट्टी लेके उसको साल्ट करके रैपर करते थे. या इन केरला सो दे आर ट्रीट गिविंग द मड थेरेपी देते, किचड़ बॉडी को ला के कुछ ओबेसिटी वगैरह कम करते, ब्लड प्रेशर कम करते, डिसीज कम करते स्किन के. दिस ऑल आर थेरेपी, दे कैन पुल द इन्फेक्टियस फ्लूड्स टुवर्ड सर्कुलेशन. सर्कुलेशन के तरफ से इन्फेक्टियस फ्लूड को पुल किया जाता है. सो दिस इज द वेरियस लोकल टेक्निक यू कैन अप्लाई इन द अर्ली स्टेज इन योर नेबर इन योर फैमिली टू अवॉइड द फर्दर कंडीशंस. लिम्फेडिमा इट इज़ वन ऑफ द वर्स्ट कंडीशन इन फ्यूचर इफ़ यू आर नॉट ट्रीटेड अर्लियर. अगर आप अर्लियर में ट्रीटमेंट नहीं दे तो फ्यूचर में बहुत प्रॉब्लम आता, पूरे लेग में से ब्लड वेसल्स रैप्चर होना स्टार्ट होते हैं आफ्टर सम टाइम बिकॉज ये इन्फेक्टियस फ्लूड है, पर्टिकुलर एक प्लेस में तो चुप नहीं बैठता. सो दैट कैन कॉज अ रैप्चर्स ऑफ ब्लड वेसल्स. ओके, इन द होल लेग ऑल ब्लड वेसल्स आर रैप्चर्स, देन इट कैन दैट इन्फेक्टियस फ्लूड कैन रीसर्कुलेट इन यूर बॉडी ऑल्सो, देन ऑर्गन्स वॉज फेल. सो दैट्स वाई इन अर्ली स्टेज यू कैन करेक्ट द लिम्फेडिमा बाय अप्लाइंग द लोकल थेरापीज, बाय आइसिंग, बाय रैपरिंग द क्लॉथ और विद द हेल्प ऑफ द सोडियम लेप. सोडियम साल्ट का लेप भी कर सकते हो, अगर इंजेक्शन लेना नहीं है यू कैन लेप द सोडियम. सोडियम से लेप कीजिए, उसका थोड़ा पेस्ट क्रीम जैसे बना के यू कैन लेप ऑन द लेग. सो दैट कैन एब्जर्व थ्रू द स्किन एंड कॉन्टैक्ट द ब्लड वेसल एंड पुल द ब्लड टूवर्ड्स अवर हार्ट. आर सम डॉक्टर्स आर देयर एक्सपर्ट्स, सो दे कैन पुल आउट द फ्लूड विद द हेल्प ऑफ इंजेक्शन. इंजेक्शन दे के वहाँ से फ्लूड को पुल आउट करते, बाहर विड्रॉल करते. सो दिस इज अ पैनिक, बट इफ योर अर्ली स्टेज योर डिटेक्टर मीन्स सो दैट वॉज हेल्पफुल. ओके, एंड एज वेल एज दिस लिम्फेडिमा कैन अवॉइड बाई गिविंग द or by following the healthy diet or balanced diet or nutritional diet. Okay, that should containing all vitamins, minerals. Okay, so amino acids, so carbohydrates, essential lipids. Such food was known as the balanced food. So that you can advise the patients. Because, so when you are healthy, automatically your brain can involved in the to regulate the proper drainage system and brain required balanced diet. So that's why you can concentrate on the balanced diet of yourself and your family and your neighbor and your patients, because balanced diet it can boost the performance of our body. If you are healthy means your patient is healthy. Agar aap healthy dikhte ho, aap healthy rehte ho, तो ऑटोमेटिक आपका पेशेंट का जो भी प्रॉब्लम है आप सुनने का कैलिबर रखते हो और सुनते हो, सुनते सुनते यू आर हैविंग क्रिएटिंग सम आंसर इन योर ब्रेन. ब्रेन में आंसर आता है कि इसको ये प्रॉब्लम है. फॉर एग्जांपल समो इज अंडर स्ट्रेस. ओके, वो एक जगह पे बैठ के काम नहीं करता है या और उसको ब्लड प्रेशर भी नॉर्मल है, बट दैट कैंडिडेट वॉज हैविंग द स्ट्रेस. उसको स्ट्रेस है बाई जस्ट सिंपल आस्किंग द क्वेश्चंस. आप उसको ऐसा क्वेश्चन पूछना चाहिए इन डायरेक्ट वे, ही शुड बी शॉर्ट. इन डायरेक्ट क्वेश्चन डायरेक्ट पूछना चाहिए, आपको स्ट्रेस है क्या? सब लोग बोलते हैं मुझे स्ट्रेस किसी का भी नहीं है. ओके, अगर वही इनडायरेक्ट क्वेश्चन पूछते हो, फॉर एग्जांपल अभी स्टूडेंट लाइफ के क्वेश्चन पूछना है, अगर आप पूछते हो इनडायरेक्टली व्हाट इज द लव. ओके, अगर लव की वजह से उसे स्ट्रेस है वो गाली देता है, शॉर्टिंग करता है, अदरवाइज He can share the melody movements. Okay, melody movements share karta. Agar melody movements share kiya, that indicate there is no stress. Agar oppose mein kuch bol raha, aap indirect question poochhe, so what is the meaning of love, I like that. Okay, wo bol deta, aisa kuch nahi, bakwas rehta, aisa rehta, ye wo rahe. That indicates he having the problem, stress related to that kind of problems. So like that, you never ask the direct question to patient, indirect. Or you ask if the family problem is there, if directly you can ask, you have any family problems? They tell, there is no. वो बोल देते हैं हमकी नहीं है. Then you ask indirectly कि तुम्हारा बेटा क्या कर रहा है, बेटी क्या कर रहा है, बहू क्या कर रहे, वो सब बोलते हैं. उनका उनका चल रहा मस्त, हमारा क्या है, ऐसे बोल देते. So like that. It indicates, so they are neglect the parents. Okay, so that negligence is the stress. That is the reason for the stress. Then that stress is responsible for the cause of the accumulation of fluid in the leg. Then your therapy is, first you can avoid the stress of that patients by giving the advice or therapy. Because no medications are available for the stress. Stress ke liye medications available nahi hai. Only your therapy and ideas. Okay, by listening to music. और आप उसको बोल सकते हैं तुम्हें कब भी बोर हुआ मेरे हॉस्पिटल में आके मेरे क्लिनिक में आके बैठो, मेरे से बात करो. या इन्वॉल्विंग देम टू इन्वॉल्व द सोशल वर्क, उनको इंसिस्ट कीजिए सोशल वर्क को इन्वॉल्व होना चाहिए. देन ऑटोमेटिक दे कैन अवॉइड द स्ट्रेस. देन योर थेरेपी वॉज सक्सेस. देन लिम्फेडिमा वॉज ट्रीटेड. ओके, सो नेक्स्ट ऑन कंडीशंस, सो दैट वॉज नोन एज द लिम्फ डेंटिटीज. ओके, सो दिस वर्ड इज एंड विद द इट इज already in the introduction chapter I told you. So if any word, if it is end with ETs, it indicates inflammations. Any word, for example, if in after my name it is the ETs, it indicates I am suffering from the inflammations. If any organ or body, if it is end with the ETs, okay, that is a hepatitis. Hepato means liver, ETs means inflammation. It means the liver is suffering from the inflammation. You should be remember this suffix. Okay, if any word suffix with it is means, so that indicates that part was suffering from the inflammation. Later on, you can find out that word. What is the lymphoma? What is the lymph? Okay, here the lymph dentis means the lymphatic system or lymph node, they are suffering from the inflammation. Okay, so that is the indications that was suffering from the inflammation. So that was known as the lymph dentis. So here the definition is, it is an infection of the lymph node usually caused by viruses, bacteria and fungi. So regarding the indications, it is look like this. Okay, in the neck or wherever it is in the neck, it is a larger. In a small lymph node also they are swell. So in this image I clearly indicates. So it is a normal neck liver, and if you are suffering from the any virus infection, bacterial infection, fungi infections or allergy reaction, due to that you are suffering from the inflammation, means some red spot is appear on the lymph node anywhere in the bodies, in the neck, okay, in the abdominal cavity or in the leg. In the leg also, if the leg having inflammation, means were also the red spots are appears. It indicates that candidate was suffering from the inflammations. Were need to give the anti-inflammatory medications, or were need to give the blood purifiers, or if it is serious, then there is need to use the antiviral drug, antibacterial drug, fungi according to further symptoms. Along with inflammation, redness, if you having the sore throat or fever, then you can categorize the whether it is related to the microorganisms, or you can use the antibiotics along with the anti-inflammatory agents. Okay, the symptoms regarding the lymphadenitis is the redness or swelling around the lymph node. Okay, so next one is the lymphocytosis. It is end with the cytosis. It indicates the abnormal increase in the count. Okay, it is end with the cytosis. Cytosis means increase, and emia means decrease, that is anemia, deficiency of the RBC. Then erythrocytosis, that indicates increase the number of RBC. So like that, the lymphocytosis means increase the number of lymphocytes. Okay, it indicates the increase the number of the lymphocytes. It can be caused by any infection or blood cancer or lymphoma. Lymphoma is one type of the lymph cancer. than autoimmune disorders. So where the lymphocytes count was increases, it indicates so that candidate was suffering from the blood cancers or lymphoma or autoimmune disorder or any type of the infections. So next one is the Hodgkin disease. It is also a lymphatic disorder. It can characterized by the painless swelling of the lymph node throughout the body. Okay, your lymph node will be the swell, but there is no pain. Okay, there is abnormal swelling of lymph node present throughout the body. They do not have any pain. So that condition was known as the Hodgkin disease or HD. If you are not corrected, then it become the cancer, or it become the malignant cancer or non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. So that's why if abnormal swelling is present in throughout your body, there is no pain, means there is need to take the care, or there is need to correct the lymphatic system functions, or you can go for the count of the lymphocytes. Okay, so here the reason for Hodgkin disease is that is HIV infection, or it is age related factors, or as well as the family history. And regarding symptoms, there is a weight loss, fever is present, then swelling of lymph node, night sweats, itchy skin, fatigue, chest pain, coughing or trouble in swallowing. Okay, in your body you are having the swelling, and along with having these symptoms means that is related to the lymphatic system. So now in the present, after quarantines, after the lockdown, many people they are suffering from these problems. Okay, so they are having a problem in the swallowing, they are problem in the coughing, they are having the night sweats, or are they having the fever. It is not related to the COVID-19, it is related to the that is the lymphatic malfunction due to sitting in the single places during the lockdowns. Okay, so in the lockdown, our all motility or locomotions are decreases. Okay, so due to that, we are placing in a single place in the home. Due to that, the fluid can be accumulated. That was responsible to cause of the inflammation in our body or create the pressure on the kidney. Okay, you can counsel your family members. Now it is your work, now you are family students. Regularly you can monitor your activities of your parents. Okay, so how their heart rate is there, blood pressure is simply by monitoring the heart rate. Okay, but with the help of the pulse or temperatures, their behavior before COVID-19, after COVID-19. If any irrational behavior is there, unnecessarily they are shouting, means it can create the stress on there. Unko stress aa raha hai. Then you can talk with them freely. Okay, unse achcha baat kijiye. That was the medications. Especially the daughter and sons, if they're talking their parent, means it is the medications. But nowadays, due to mechanical life, we are not talk with our mothers and not talk with our fathers. Okay, you don't need to give the money. You simply talk. Mother se baat kijiye, father se baat kijiye, brother chota hai aapse, unse baat kijiye, bade unse baat kijiye. Okay. उनसे पूछिए क्या चल रहा है, क्या नहीं, वर्क प्रॉब्लम क्या. दे कैन शेयर देयर आर प्रॉब्लम्स. इफ दे आर शेयरिंग द प्रॉब्लम्स विद यू, मीन दे आर फ्री फ्रॉम द स्ट्रेस. या पेरेंट्स सोचते हैं बाबा मेरे बेटी मुझे पूछ रही है, कुछ बोलना चाहिए. मदर बोलती कि वो नहीं तो मैं हूँ, नहीं मैं मुझे कोई नहीं तो मेरी बेटी है. ओके, दे आर थिंकिंग लाइक दैट समवन इज विद देम. ओके, सो दिस इज द एक्चुअली नीडेड इन नाउ इन द क्वारंटीन लाइफ, इन द कोविड-19 लाइफ, बिकॉज we all is present. Or you can arrange the small games in your home itself. Bahar mat jaye, abhi bhi covid bahut phail raha hai. Ghar ke andar hi kuch activities kijiye. Okay, kabhi aap khana banaye, kabhi mother ko banega, brother ko, even father ko involve kijiye. Papa aapka khana kaisa banta hum dekhenge. He enjoy the life. Okay, then they are free from the stress. If they are free from stress, means they are free from the all kind of the serious disorder, mental disorder, or GIT disorders, any other disorders that was related to the this current scenarios. That is the work as a pharmacy students, as a doctor of pharmacy student, because you are the only one candidate. With the help of only your talk or your words, you can enhance the life of the patients and prevent the disorder diseases without any medications. Also, it is possible. So here the Hodgkin disease, that is swelling of the lymph nodes throughout the body, then these are the symptoms. If any swelling, then you monitor these symptoms. If it is there, means you can consult the doctors, or if you are able to take the medications after 50 years ke baad aapke paas able hota hai ki what medications are required, how the lymphoma or WBC count can be decreased, everything you can be know. Okay, so they were able to give the medications also. Next one is the non-Hodgkin lymphoma. Okay, it is actually one type of the malignant cancer. Okay, cancer, they are different types. One is the neoplasma. In particular places, the growth of the cell is increases, that is abnormal. Okay, in the particular part of the body, abnormal growth of cell is increases, that was known as the neoplasma or cancer. If it is malignancy, means where the healthy, that is a cancer cell, it can invade the healthy cells, aazu bazu healthy cells ko bhi invade karta, cancer mein convert karwata hai. Okay, so that was known as the malignant cancer or malignancy. So here the non-Hodgkin lymphoma is one type of the malignant cancer. It can caused by the producing the too many abnormal white blood cells. Okay, increase the abnormal white blood cells. So that was known as the non-Hodgkin lymphoma. It is one type of the malignant cancer. These abnormal white blood cells, they can cause the cancer to the healthy white blood cells also. Okay, so that condition was known as the non-Hodgkin lymphoma. So here the white blood functions is decreases, simply the function, the symptoms are, even the person was suffering from the unnecessary allergy. In small change of environment, he's suffering from the badness or unhealthy because of decreased immunity. Change of water, he's suffering from the fever. So these are the one type of the early symptoms of the any abnormalities in the blood cells, including the non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. So next one is the tonsillitis. It is also end with the itis. It means inflammation in the tonsil organs. Okay, that is the swelling or inflammation of tonsils due to bacterial and viral infection. Okay, regularly you can monitor your tonsils by observing your oral cavity in the mirror. If it is swell, means it indicates whatever taken the air, whatever taken the food, so that was rich of microorganisms. Even the case of COVID-19, regularly you can observe tonsils, because tonsils are the prime organs or main organ or first organs. It was involved in the defense mechanism in the oral cavity. Already you learn in the introductions. Introduction aap learn kiya ki tonsil ek aisa organ hai ki pehla wo defend command karta hai jo bhi microorganism hota, because tonsils are the storers for the lymphocytes and beta cells, that B lymphocytes and T lymphocytes. If any microorganisms comes in the oral cavity through air, water and food, so they are involved to secrete the T lymphocytes, kills the microorganisms. During that, the tonsils are swelled out. That indicates in whatever the environment is there, so that was the polluted with the viruses. Maybe COVID, maybe any others, maybe bacteria. So that's why by observing the tonsil function, it can give the idea regarding the entry of the bacteria, viruses, microorganisms in our body. So here the tonsillitis, it is inflammations due to bacterial and viral infections. So next one is the splenomegaly, and also known as the hypersplenism. That is the enlargement of the size of spleen due to stress or viral infections. Okay, just observing. So these positions of your body, this is a normal spleen and this is the abnormal splenomegaly. And that is splenomegaly, nothing but to increase the size of the spleen. Okay, or swelling of the spleen is known as the splenomegaly. So that was occurred due to stress or viral infection. Agar aapko viral infection dekhna hai, you can look out the portions of the this in your body. If it is swell out, that indicates we are suffering the viral infection or stress. And also certain increase the blood pressure or hypertension cases, then also the splenomegaly is occurs. So these are three conditions where the person was suffering from the splenomegaly or hypersplenism, it is nothing but the enlargement of the size of the spleen due to stress or viral infections. So these are the various lymphatic disorders. So with the help of the signs and symptoms, you should be monitor the patients and you have create your own capability to treat that ones. If any other ideas are there, you can list out. So an idea was created. So when you know the risk factor, so when you know the symptoms, so then only the idea was created. For example, abhi splenomegaly hai. आपको मालूम हुआ स्प्लीनोमेगली इज अकर ड्यू टू अकुमुलेशन ऑफ सोडियम. ऐसा नहीं होता, मैं जनरल बोल रहा हूँ.